गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, आई हैव ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन द चैप्टर अ गिफ्ट ऑफ चप्पल्स इन डिटेल। लेट्स हैव समरी ऑफ दिस चैप्टर। वन आफ्टरनून मृदु वेंट टू हर आंट रुकुमनीज हाउस। शी वेंट देयर टू मीट हर कजिन्स लाली, रवि एंड मीना। रवि ड्रैग्ड हर टू द बैकयार्ड। देयर इनसाइड अ टॉर्न फुटबॉल ले अ वेरी स्मॉल किटन ड्रिंकिंग मिल्क। Meena said that they had found the kitten outside the gate that morning, but it was kept secret. Amma had a fear that Pati would go away if she knows about the cat in the house. Ravi had succeeded by tact in getting a little milk for the kitten. The children named it Mahendran. It was a fine breed of cat. Ravi gave a detailed account of the cat's family and relatives. He said the cat was the descendant of the Mahabalipuram Rishi cat. Meena and Mridu smiled at his cooked-up story. The cat was frightened to hear Ravi's sound. He fled from his place. Lali was learning to play the violin. She wasn't doing well, although the music master was trying his best to make her learn. Mridu went up to the window. She saw Lali sitting with her violin. In front of her, there was the bony music teacher. He had a mostly bald head. He was wearing a gold chain around his neck and diamond ring on his hand. A beggar came at the gate. The mother told Ravi to send him away. She was chatting with Tapi. The beggar's voice irritated her. She complained that he was coming there every day. The beggar was already in the garden. He had spread a piece of cloth under the neem tree. He leant against the tree trunk, waiting for the alms. Alms means food. Ravi told him sternly, harshly, to go away. The beggar sat up and sighed. He told that he would go away after taking some rest. Then the children got sympathetic towards him. Mridu asked Meena and Ravi if they had got an old pair of slippers in the house. Ravi went to search. Mridu noticed a pair of chappals in the veranda. These were shabby looking but sturdy, but durable. He gave it to the old man to wear and asked him never again to come back. The beggar blessed the children. He pushed his feet into the slippers and left in a hurry. The music teacher searched for his chappals in the veranda. He said his slippers were brand new and expensive also. Rukumani came there with Pati. She rightly guessed that it was the mischief played by the children. She was upset and angry. She went indoors and brought Gopu Mama's new chappals and gave them to the music master. She apologized to the master on behalf of her son, Ravi. The music master's eyes lit up with joy. He put them on and called children naughty monkeys. The mother didn't like Ravi being called a monkey. She went inside the house. She thanked God that Gopu Mama's chappals were there. But she laughed to think how much upset would he be on his return. She declared that she would take all the blame on herself.